sweep our arms up wide. Big breath in, filling up those lungs, sweeping your arms out, up and wide, reaching those fingertips up towards the sky as you lift your chin up. Feel those lungs, feel your rib cage expanding out laterally, and then exhale, sweeping those arms back down as you do. Deflate those lungs and allow that rib cage to come back into normal position. Let's do that again, ready? Big breath in. And exhale. And one more time, big breath in. Reaching those arms up high, and exhale. Go ahead and place each hand on either knee. Relax those shoulders. And then go ahead and just roll that belly around, loosening up our spine, opening up that vertebrae. Rolling around, just let the hips relax on the ground. Try not to let your hips lift up as you roll around your torso in one direction, and then reverse the rotation. A few more belly rolls. Last one, and back to the center. Place the right hand on the outside of that right thigh, palm on the floor. Big breath in as we sweep our left arm up and over. Gaze up towards the ceiling, extending those left fingertips over into the right. And you should feel a stretch on your left side. Reach, reach, reach. Breathe in as we extend that arm back over, and then sweep the right arm up and over. Opposite side here. Let's do that one more time. Ready? Breathe in, bringing your right hand down over to the right side. Exhale, the left arm up over. And breathe in again through the nose. Exhale, over to the left side. Right arm over to the left side. And back to the center. Bring those arms out wide. Sit up as straight as you can. So nice straight spine. Lift that chest up. Shoulders are soft here. Arms out wide. What we're going to do is go ahead and pulse those arms back. As you do, vertebrae together, little pulses here. So you're really trying to open up those arms as wide as possible. And you want to feel an expansion in your chest as you do this as well. So you're squeezing your shoulder blades and you're expanding your chest. Keep breathing. A few more of these pulses. Let's go for 3, 2, 1. Keep those arms elevated. Rotate those palms back behind you and then pulse those palms back behind you. Keep pulsing here. Little pulses. Nice job. Let's go for 3, 2, 1, and then we're going to bring the palms of our hands together. Open those elbows out wide. Lift those palms so they're just about at your nose level here. Gaze in between those palms. Breathe in. Exhale, keeping your gaze in between those palms as you twist over slowly to the right. Only twist as far as your spine will allow. Not too fast. Slow, slow, slow. Breathe in as you come back to the center. Still warming up here, and then exhale over to the left side. Let's do that one more time on each side. Breathe in as we come back to the center. Exhale over to the right side. And again, breathe in, back to the center. And last time, exhale over to the left side. And then bring everything back into the center here. Go ahead and release those hands down. Place that right hand again on the outside of that right thigh. Fairly straight arm here. We're going to take that left hand, bend your elbow, place the palm of your hand back behind that head. Lift your chest up here. Let's breathe in. Exhale. We're just going to twist over to the right side, bringing our elbow down. You want to feel like your spine is rotating here. And then bring that back up. And let's do a few more times on this side like this. Nice twist in your spine. Don't push the back of your head forward. Your hand is just there for support. And last time. And let's do the opposite side. Bring the left hand down now on that left side. Right hand comes right back behind your head. Right elbow out wide. Lifting that chest up here. Breathe in. Exhale. We're going to twist over to the left side now. Breathe in as we come back up. And exhale. And let's just keep doing a few more of these. Open up that elbow out wide when you lift it up, and then do as much arms up wide. Gaze up to the ceiling, then exhale. One more time, breathe in. And exhale. Nice job. All right, we're gonna twist over and make our way into a box position. So turning on over gently. So those hands are directly underneath your shoulders. Those knees are directly underneath your hips. We're in a box position here. Okay, we're gonna take it to the next step. Go ahead and take that right foot back and then take that left foot back into a plank position here. Now we're gonna, you can just hang out here for a little bit if you like, but we're gonna do some, add to this movement here. Two things before we continue. Lift that chest up, tuck that tailbone under and tighten your abs here. A little bit softness in the knees, don't lock them out too much. Okay? And all we're gonna do at this point, again, you can hang here, or we're gonna breathe in and then exhale as we bring that knee in towards our chin and then place that foot back. And we'll do the opposite on the left side. Okay, so right to left, really squeeze as you draw that knee in towards your chest or your chin. Side to side. Now as you do this, you want to also be mindful of your balance and not too far forward or not too far back. You want to have equal balance or equal weight approximately on those two hands and then alternating feet. A few more times on each side. Let's do one more time on each side. Nice job. Go ahead and lower both knees. Bring those knees back underneath your hips. Let's do a few cat-cows. Breathe in as we pull that tailbone under. Lift up our chest. And then exhale. We're going to round out our spine. Tuck your chin under and your tailbone under as well. Opening up our shoulders. And let's just do a few more of these cat-cows. Last one. Nice job. And then back into a neutral back. So again, you want to have equal weight on all those two hands and those knees here. Go ahead and tap the top of your feet on the ground. Nice little massage on those feet. An area that often gets neglected. We stuff them into shoes and things, but we don't necessarily take care of that part of our anatomy. So take care of this. It's nice to do. Okay, so from here, the next set of moves, you could stay on your knees. Or you want to take it to make it more challenging, go ahead and tuck those toes under and then lift up those knees so they're just elevated above the ground here. Okay? Anchor those left toes in. We're going to elevate the right toes. We're going to lift the knee up to the right and back down. Like a dog doing his thing on a fire hydrant. Keep going. Let's go for five, four, three, two, and one more, one, and then bring those toes down and bring your knees down if they're not already. Okay, we're gonna do that again, breathe in, exhale, elevate those knees. We're gonna add to this, so we're gonna sweep that right knee up to the side, and then we're gonna draw that knee in towards our chin and back. So out to the side, down, and then in, and keep going. Let's do five more of these sets here.
Five sets of these out to the side.
Keep going from side to side. Keep breathing. Let's do two more on each side. One more each side.
Steps. We're going to do the next. We're going to hold for count of 10.
Everybody ready? Breathe in. Exhale, lift up your arms and your legs. Lift them up as high as you can. Let's hold for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and we're going to lower back down. Good job. We're going to take that to 15. That'll be our top. So ready? Breathe in, exhale, and lift. And hold for 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and come back down. We're going to work our way down. So next we're going to do it from the count of 10. Breathe in, exhale, lift. Maybe you can lift those ones up even higher. Hold for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and we're going to come back down. Alright, last we're going to do for just 5 seconds. Breathe in, exhale, lift here. And this time, go ahead and hold for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and come back down. Now you can rest your hands, you can cross your hands in front of you, rest your head on your hands here. We're going to relax our upper body. Go ahead and bring your legs back into about hip distance apart here. And breathe in, exhale, let's lift our right leg. Let's lift our left leg. Rotate those feet, toes away from you so you're trying to, your heels are towards each other. And then what we're going to do is we're going to squeeze our glutes to bring those heels together and then open those legs back up. And keep going. Try to keep your legs as straight as possible as you draw those heels and those legs together. If they don't come all the way together, that is okay. You're still going to feel those glute muscles, your inner thighs, back in your hands. Working, doing their thing to try to bring those legs together. Just a few more here. And if it hurts your lower back, don't bring those legs. You might open up those legs a little bit wider and just draw them close from that back, or bring them all the way together. So play around with it, adjust as you need to. And keep going.
Feel
difference in how you feel. Let's do one more here. Last one, and then come all the way down. And let's make our way gently over to the opposite side. So I will be on my right side. Again, that right elbow now is underneath the right shoulder. Palm of your hand is facing forward. Bend the knees. You can place that left hand on top of your hip here. And we've got our heels together. Lift those heels and then open and close the left knee. Try to bring that knee up as high as you can. You're going to feel a squeeze in your muscles. It'll feel harder the more you try to lift that up. As well as fighting against gravity. So resisting the gravity to control the movement down. Keep going. Let's go for three. Two. And last one. One. Nice job. Go ahead and lower that right heel, keeping the right leg in the same shape. Extend that left leg. Again, you want to have a nice straight line stacking those hips here. Adjust as you need to. Let's take a breath in. Exhale. We're going to lift our hips straight up and then lift the left leg up and down and lower the hips. And continue. So another thing to focus on is to just focus on your lower obliques here. Squeeze them to lift and lower the hips. That'll also take pressure on areas like your shoulder. Thank you. together and not from side to side. Give yourself a nice little squeeze, nice little break. So from here, let's do single leg stretch. So extend that left leg out away from you, hovering that leg. We're gonna keep the right knee where it's at, but let's place our left hand on the top of that right shin and the right hand just on the top of our right ankle. You can keep your head down or tuck your chin under, lift that head up, and then we're gonna switch from right to left. Again, make sure that head is not falling back. Try to keep the top of your head or the crown of your head pointing towards the ceiling or the sky if you happen to be outside. Going single leg stretch, don't hold your breath. Breathing. A few more. Got three, two, and one more. One. Nice job. Lower your head. Bring those knees back in. Wrap your arms around them. Squeeze them tight and rock them side to side. Here we're going to go through the double leg stretch. Same thing, but we're bringing both legs together and sinking their movement. Okay, so let's go ahead once again. You can keep your head down or tuck your chin under. Lift your chest and your head. And then we're going to release those fingers as we sweep those feet away from us and then sweep the arms around and then bring it all together. And keep going.
Take that right leg straight up overhead. You can have your hands
tee up your arms so your palms are facing down, straight line from those right fingertips to the left fingertips. Bring your legs back up into tabletop, spring the legs together. Take a breath in, exhale as we bring those knees over to the right side. Keep your shoulders on the ground and make sure your head twists in the opposite direction of those legs. And hover those legs for 3, 2, 1. Breathe in as we bring them back up to the center. Exhale those legs over to the left side. And hold for 3, 2, 1. And bring them back up to the center. We're going to do that again. You can keep your knees bent or straighten those legs. Bring them over to the right side. Hold and hover for 3, 2, 1. Breathe in as you bring those legs back up and over. Exhale to lower them to the left side. And hold and hover for 3, 2, 1. And bring them back up to the center. Go ahead and bring those knees back in again. Squeeze those tight and rock from side to side. All right. So we're going to go ahead and extend the right leg out. We're going to extend the left leg out. And we're going to make our way into a seated position. Let's bring our right arm up overhead, left arm up overhead. Take a breath in as you exhale. Lift up your head, and we're going to roll up one vertebra at a time. We're going to use those abs to lift ourselves up. Now, if you need to place your hands down here for support, that's fine too. Try to use those abs and move all the way up into a straight back. Pull those toes towards you. Let's take a sit-up, a straight back as high as possible here. Breathe in. Exhale, we're going to lean back just a little bit. Breathe in as we come back up. Exhale, we're going to push those fingertips away from us and then gaze in between your knees. Your arms are on either side of your ear. Reach and extend. Let's do that again. Breathe in as we come back up. Exhale, we're going to lean back this time. Pull that navel and we're going to roll back just a little bit. So you have, it's not a straight back, it's an arch in your back here. Let's hold here. And let's go ahead and breathe in as we come back to a straight back. Exhale as we push those fingertips forward again. And breathe as we come back to a straight back. Bring your hands down on either side. Get back on the mat here. When you have your elbows back behind, you're going to lift your chest up too. That'll help. What we're going to do is go ahead and bend your left knee. The sole of your left foot comes on the ground. Point your right toe, a little bit bend in that right knee. Use those abs as we lift and lower that right leg. Straight up, straight down. Squeeze. So just below your belly button. This is an area you want to think about trying to of course, you're going to feel that in your leg muscles as well. But we want to engage our abs because that will help to lift and lower that leg. Let's go for 3, 2. And last one, 1. Keep that leg elevated. Push it out to the side and back. 5, 4, 3, 2. And last one, 1. And then what we're going to do is keep that leg elevated. Draw the knee in towards your chest. Don't hover back. Keep that chest up and then extend that foot. Draw it in and extend. So really think about trying to sit up as tall as you can, as straight as you can. Focus, use those muscles. Concentrate to bring that knee toward your chest. Squeeze and extend. Let's do 2 more. 2, and last one, 1. Nice job. All right, go ahead and place your hands back behind your thigh here, drawing that knee toward your chest. You're going to straighten and then bend that right leg. And don't round out your back, so lift up to sit up as straight as possible. And let's go for 2, and 1 more. 1, nice job. Go ahead and lower that right foot. Place your hands back on either side. Extend that left leg out from in front of you. Adjust as you need to. Point the left toes, and let's lift and lower the left leg. And let's go for 5, 4, 3, 2. And nice job. Last one. That leg out to the side and back in. Don't let that leg fall down if you can. If you have to take a break, I get it. But try to push through here. Keep going. We've got 2, and last one. 1. Keep that leg elevated. We're going to draw that knee in towards our chest and push that leg away. So squeeze, bring that knee in, and then extend. Keep going. Let's go for 5 more. We've got 5, 4. Last 1, 1. Nice job. Place those hands back behind that thigh. Draw that knee in towards your chest, sitting up straight, and then straighten and bend the left leg. Now, if your knee is popping and making noises, and well, then, you know, of course adjust as you need to. Maybe you're not going to straighten that leg all the way. And last one, nice job. All right, so go ahead and bring those knees over to the side. We're going to make our way up. Let's make our way into a box position here. We're going to tuck those toes, hands are underneath your shoulders. Go ahead and bring the knees back a little bit, pass behind you, pass back and past your hips there. Tuck those toes under. And when you're ready, take a breath in. Exhale, we're going to push that in to the base of our spine as we lift those hips straight up and make our way into a downward dog. So your feet are about hip distance apart. Push your head back on either side, so your arms are on either side of your ears here. And then you may paddle out your feet. Think about drawing that knee to the base of your spine and trying to keep those hips lifted as much as you can. A few more times. Nice job. And then go ahead and stick that right foot. We're going to draw back behind and lift that right leg straight up behind us. And then let's go ahead and lift and lower our left heel. Keep that right leg lifted up back behind you. Lifting and lowering the left heel.
Job. Five, four, three, two,
of our left heel, and let's pulse here for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Go ahead and lower that left heel, lift your right heel, and pulse for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And we're gonna stay down. We're just gonna lift and lower each heel, left to right, left to right. Keep those abs tight, keep that tailbone tucked under. When we get tired, we might wanna push that booty back to compensate. And what happens is that actually is harder on our body than taking advantage of those muscles that we can use to prevent any kind of injuries and so forth. Last one, go ahead and lower both heels. And then what we're gonna do is we're going to go ahead, bring our arms up overhead, and we're just gonna get down, head, and up as we swing our arms. And let's keep going. Keep breathing. Again, as you lower that tush, make sure to keep those knees out wide.
Control the movement up and control the movement down.
light toe tap as that 10 foot comes down towards the ground. Lifting and lowering. Then we have 3, 2, and last one, 1. Nice job. Let's bring that knee up. We're going to flex or bend that knee and straighten. Bend and straighten. Let's do 5 more. We have 5, 4, 3, 2, and last one, 1. Nice job. And let's see, we're going to go ahead and lower that leg and then rotate that left knee out to the left side, draw that heel towards you, and then lift and lower. It's just a slight rotation. That's all that it takes to make a difference in which muscles that you use. Going, we're going to do 5, 4, 3, 2, and last one, 1. And then go ahead and lower that leg, let's straighten your leg, lift it just enough that you can draw circles with that foot and that leg. More here, 3, 2, and last one, 1, and we're going to go ahead and roll that leg around, 3, 2, and 1, and then go ahead and lower that leg, and then roll around your right ankle, maybe your left ankle, just a few more times here, okay? And then you want to adjust or make your way to a place that you have enough room in front of you, because we're going to take advantage of that space. Feet are about hip distance apart. And go ahead. Actually, let's take a breath in as we dip our arms free. We've got to fill up those lungs. Oxygen, you got one. Breathe up, ease it toward the sky. Exhale your hands back behind you. One more time. Ready? Breathe in through your nose. Sweeping those arms up high and exhale. And keep your arms where they're at. Breathe in. Exhale. This time we're going to roll down. Tuck that chin under and roll down 1 vertebrae at a time. Slowly, slowly. And when your hands come down to the mat, walk them forward into a forward plane. When you get down there, make sure that those hands are equal weight on the hands and those toes. And then you want to adjust your core as well. So tighten those out. Keep those tail touch under. Squeeze your glutes. And what we're going to do is we're going to take those. Let's bring our hands together. We're going to make a heart shape underneath our heart. So if you gaze down, you should see your forefinger and the thumbs are together. And then from here, we're going to bring our elbows down so we put some push-ups here. Now, if you don't want to do straight legs, you can always lower your knees, bring your hips up, bring your heels up, and do your push-ups this way. Whichever way works better for you. Let's do 5 push-ups. Last one, and go ahead and lower those knees. Now we're going to rotate those hands so they're back underneath our shoulders here. And again, you can make your way to a plank, a straight leg plank, bend your knee, or bend your knees, cross your feet. But this time we're going to do push-ups, so we're going to tuck in those elbows tucked in by your side as we lower our head and our chest straight down. And down. So I'm going to do the knee push-ups. Alright, and after you've done those 5, go ahead and we're going to work on our triceps. So we're going to make our way, it's our last thing in the forward plan. We're about there. Go ahead and bring your hands back behind you. Your hands are underneath your shoulders here. Okay, your legs are about hip distance apart. When you're ready, let's go ahead and lift that booty up. Lift that chest up. You want to keep your elbows tucked in by your side as you bend them straight down and up. Down and up. And keep doing this. Straight down and up. So we're using the back sides of our arms here. Let's do 5 of these for 5, 4, 3, 2, and last one. Come all the way down. You know, we're not done with these. We did 2 sets with the other way in our push-ups, so we're going to do another set on this position here. in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and we're done. Good job. So open those knees up, bring your heels together, and push back into a child's pose. Oh gosh, feel good. Nice job. And go ahead and walk those hands back towards your knees, and let's make our way to where we started in the seated position. Crossing our legs. And just kind of settle in, rocking back and forth. So you can always place one foot on top of the other if that feels better for you. And then when you're ready, let's place the right hand on the outside of that right thigh. Big breath in. As we sweep that left arm up, you know, we're gazing towards the ceiling. Nice big stretch, we earned this. And then breathe it as we come back up. Exhale over to the right side, your left side, right arm over to the left side. And then breathe in as we come back up. Place the back side of that left hand on the outside of that right knee. Right hand comes back behind you just below your tailbone. Breathe in as we lift our chest up. Exhale as we twist over to the right side. And breathe in as we come back up. Exhale over to the left side. And breathe in as we come back to the center. Okay, let's place our hands together here. We're going to cross them, bending our elbows, grab opposite shoulder blades with opposite hands, opening those shoulder blades up. Lift your chest up and give yourself a nice big hug as you rotate from side to side. A few more times. And let's bring our hands in front of us. Take the palms away from you. Bring them back behind you. Clasp your hand. Lower those shoulders. Tuck your chin under as you draw those hands up back behind you. You can even lower your head and bring your hands up even more. And go ahead and release. Okay, bring your hands in front of you. Big breath in. Exhale as you walk those hands away from you. Lowering your head and your chest. And take a nice big bend. Breath in. Walk those hands back and then reverse the cross of our legs. And then once again, we'll do that. Breathe in, exhale, walk those hands away from you. You should feel a good stretch here in your thighs, especially your hips. Lower back, your shoulders. And then go ahead and walk those hands back up. And finally, let's take a big breath in. Exhale as we sweep those arms up high, gaze up towards the ceiling. And exhale those arms down by your side. One more time, ready for a big breath in. As you draw your hands together, exhale, slowly lower those hands, bringing your thumbs to your heart center. Tuck your chin under and give yourself a nice big bow. Rewarding yourself for a job well done. And thank you so much for joining in.